Cause there's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight. I know you by a friendly face. There's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight.
This has been a lifelong dream for both of us and our group, singing and playing with the Kingston Trio, and we're really excited. I think the music then was the type of music that you can really listen to. You can hear all the words, you can hear the guitars, you can hear the picking, and most of that music at that time had a message.
Our admiration for the Kingston Trio, or of the Kingston Trio, started when I entered Wyoming Seminary in 1958. Kingston Trio had just become popular then, and I can remember being extremely impressed by the upperclassmen at Wyoming Seminary who had parties just to listen to Kingston Trio albums. Okay, you know, they would, the whole party would be based on listening to Kingston Trio music. That's where I became really taken with the Kingston Trio's music and started to learn it. I went out and bought a guitar, the very guitar that I'm playing to this day. And it had to be a Martin guitar, just like the Kingston Trio. Everything was modeled after the Kingston Trio.
We've been playing the music of the Kingston Trio since I have been 14. So that's about 30 years that we've been doing that type of music. We have three members other than my brother and myself in our group. We have Reverend Don Lyon, who is a great guitar player and a great singer, and Perry Orfanello. Orfanella, as you know, is a great bass player, and Carl Cole, who is very good on the banjo. And we're so excited that they're playing with us and will be with us the night that we play with the Kingston Trio. Everything we do, I think the greater percentage of the money is going to worthy causes. So we're happy about that. That's one way we can help mankind. And I think performing for me is a relaxation. It just takes my mind off of medicine and makes me very happy. And I just like to sing and I like to perform. And I especially like to do it when people are enjoying it. And, you know, it's amazing. A crowd is so special, and they'll tell you in certain ways whether they like what they're hearing or they don't like what they're hearing. They'll either be very quiet and they won't applaud, or they will applaud just to be nice, but you can feel it. And when you know that the audience really is liking what you're doing, it's just special, and it just makes you so good, and just makes you feel special. And that's what I like about performing.
In the early morning rain, with a dollar in my hand, with an aching in my heart, and my pockets full of sand, I'm a long way from home, and I miss my darling so. In the early morning rain, with no place to go, out on runway number 9, big 707 said to go, but I'm stuck here on the grass, where the cold winds blow. Well, the liquor tasted good, and the women all were fast. There she goes, my friend. She's away in westward bound, high above the clouds she'll fly, where the morning rain don't fall, and the sun always shines. She'll be flying on my home.
This old airport's got me down. It's no earthly good to me, 'cause I'm stuck here on the ground, cold and drunk as I can be. You can jump a jet plane like you can a freight train. So I best be on my way in the early morning rain. You can jump a jet plane like you can a freight train.
Thank you very, very much. You know, I know Angie does a lot of emergency medicine, and that gets your blood flowing and your heart pumping, and it's very exciting. And I argue jury trials, and there's 12 people there, or sometimes a panel of 9 judges. And the preacher here probably does, what, maybe a speech before 300 or 400 people at a time. But never this. For any of us, and believe me, it's exciting, and thank you so much for your warm welcome. That's awesome. Now, I'm sure there are fellow physicians out there. We might need one with this next song, because this is where Angie usually hurts himself. Don't you weep, don't you mourn.
Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. In Pharaoh's army get drowned dead. Oh, Mary, don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. In Pharaoh's army get drowned dead. Oh, Mary, don't you weep.
If I could, I surely would stand on the rock where Moses stood. Did Pharaoh's army get drowned?
Oh, Mary, don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Did Pharaoh's army get drowned? Oh, Mary, don't you weep.
Satan's mad and he knows I'm glad. He missed that soul that he thought he had. Didn't Pharaoh's army get drowned?
Oh, Mary, don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Didn't Pharaoh's army get drowned? Oh, Mary, don't you weep.
Cheer up, brothers, don't you cry. There'll be good days by and by. Didn't Pharaoh's army get drowned?
Oh, Mary, don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Didn't Pharaoh's army get drowned? Oh, Mary, don't you weep. This whole world is gonna reel and rock. In Pharaoh's army get drowned. Oh, Mary, don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. In Pharaoh's army get drowned. Oh, Mary, don't you weep. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Oh, Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. In Pharaoh's army get drowned.
Mary, don't you weep.
Thank you.
haven't got a mansion. I haven't any land. Not one paper dollar to cringle in my hand. And I can show you morning on a thousand hills, and kiss you and give you seven daffodils, and kiss you and give you seven daffodils. I haven't got a fortune to buy you pretty things, but I can give you moonbeams for necklaces and rings. And I can show you morning on a thousand hills, and kiss you and give you seven daffodils, and kiss you and give you seven daffodils. Seven golden daffodils shining in the sun will light our way to evening when the day is done. And I can give you music and a crust of bread, a pillow of tiny boughs to rest your head, a pillow of tiny boughs to rest your head. I haven't got a mansion, I haven't any land, not one paper dollar to cringle in my hand. And I can show you morning on a thousand hills, and kiss you and give you seven daffodils, and kiss you and give you seven daffodils.
Some come to dance, some come to play, some merely come to pass time away. Some come to laugh, their voices do ring, but as for me, I come for to sing. 'Cause there's a meeting here tonight, there's a meeting here tonight. I know you by a friendly face, there's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight.
I hear it.
There's a meeting here tonight. I know you by your friendly face. There's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight. Great God, I'm glad you came along. Hope all your brothers and your sisters here will help me sing this song. There's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight. I know you by your friendly face. There's a meeting here tonight. There's a smile on every upturned face and a smile in every eye. Brothers and sisters, let me hear you shout. Let me hear your joyful cry. There's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight. I know you by your friendly face. There's a meeting here tonight.
Hey, there's a meeting here. There's one big meeting here. I know you by your friendly face. There's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight. I know you by your friendly face. There's a meeting here tonight. There's a meeting here tonight. Great God, there's a meeting here tonight. Great God, I know you by your friendly face. There's a meeting
And welcome the Kingston Trio. Here they come.
Of this old town.
Tell me, buddy.
That's where my true love lays around. She sits down upon another's knee and tells him what she never will tell me.
Oh, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard to love one who never did love you, you, you. Oh, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard, great God, to love one who never will be true.
Well, the first time I saw my true love, she was standing by the door. And the last time I saw her false-hearted smile, she was dead on that barroom floor.
Oh, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard to love one who never did love you. Oh, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard, great God, to love one who never will be true.
Well, now, who's gonna kiss your pretty lips?
I will.
Gonna hold your little hand.
I will.
And who's gonna do well? You know what? When I'm down in that promised land.
Oh, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard to love one who never did love you. Oh, well, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard, great God, to love one who never will be true.
All right.
It's the meanest damn place in this town. Oh, well, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard to love one who never did love you. Oh, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard, great God, to love one who never will be true.
You know,
oh, it's hard, ain't it hard, ain't it hard to love one who never did love you.
Yes, it's all so very hard,
hard, ain't it hard, great God, to love one who never will be true.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
God.
Thank you. Wow, you guys are wild.
Y'all look so old, I don't know.
This is one of our favorite ballads written by these two boys. It's called Chilly Winds. I'd shine my light on
that cool Colorado rain. Out where them chilling winds don't blow. If you're feeling lonely, you're feeling low. Remember that I love you more than you will ever know. Go where them chilly winds don't blow. Leaving in the springtime won't be back till fall. If I can't forget you, I might not come back at all. Out where them chilly winds don't blow. Out where them chilly winds don't blow. Out where them chilly winds don't blow.
Yes,
thank you very much. This is our 36th year on the road.
37.
It'll be 37 years in June of 1993. He doesn't know.
It is much better to be rich and healthy than poor and sick.
Nixon, 72. In 1963, we were living in San Francisco, and we released a song that was destined to become a classic for its time period. We were innovators when we were young. We released a song that had a four-letter word on it, and we tried to sell to the American public filth in 1963. In 1963 in San Francisco, they had two FM stations who would only play this song very late at night. The AM stations who made the hit said, get rid of the word or we can't even get it played. We went back to Capitol Records, set up the whole studio to do this over the word. Tonight, we'd like to do it in its raw, uncensored form. And give you a real taste of filth from 1963.
Oh, yeah.
Some people say I'm a no account. Others say I'm no good. But I'm just a natural born traveling man. Doing what I think I should. Oh, yeah. Doing what I think I should.
Here it is. Filth.
And I don't give a damn about a greenback dollar.
That was it.
Spend it fast as I can. For a wailing song and a good guitar. The only things that I understand. Oh boy, the only things that I understand.
Go!
When I was a little baby, my mama said, hey son, get out. Travel where you will and grow to be a man and sing what must be sung. Oh, yeah. Sing what must be sung.
Here it is again.
And I don't give a damn about a greenback dollar. Spend it fast as I can for a wailing song and a good guitar. They only think that I understand. Oh, boy. They only think that I understand. Now that I'm a grown man, I've traveled here and there. I've learned that a bottle of brandy and the song, the only ones who ever care. Oh boy,
only ones who ever care.
Hey, now don't give a damn about a greenback dollar. Bend it fast as I can. For a wailing song and a good guitar. The only things that I understand. Oh boy, the only things that I understand. Oh yeah, the only things that I understand. Oh boy, the only things that I understand. Give a damn about a greenback dollar.
Sorry, man.
Spend as fast as I can.
Stop it.
For a wailing song and a good guitar. The only things that I understand. Oh, boy. The only things that I understand. Oh, yeah. The only things that I understand. Oh, boy. The only things that I understand.
All right.
Oh.
Calypso time.
We started our group in 1957, just out of business school in California. What else do you do with a business degree? And we noticed right away that other people seemed to sing calypso a lot better than we did. We tried for a short while to sell ourselves as an albino steel band. But the Winter Brothers got uptight, so you know.
Yeah. Them and James.
This is a calypso song that we recorded in 1959 or 60, which they actually played on the radio when they wouldn't play Greenback Dollar because they had damn on it 3 years later. But this is an interesting song, and it was written in 1938 or 39, and we were down about 4 or 5 years ago on a cruise ship, playing a cruise ship in the Bahamas. We stopped off in Nassau to have lunch with some friends of ours. And they took us to a nice little club, and it had a fellow over against the wall with a little amplifier playing an old beat-up guitar, singing the old calypso song. And most of the time down there now they play reggae stuff, but he was playing the old calypso songs that we knew. And he played this next song, and I couldn't resist it. I got up from lunch, and I just walked over, and I said, "Say, where'd you learn that song?" He said, "Off an old Kingston Trio record, man."
Everything we say is true, also.
There lived a family with much confusion, as you will see. There was a mama and a papa and a son who was young, who wanted to marry, have a wife of his own. Ah, woe, ah, me. Shame and scandal of their family. Ah, woe, ah, me. Shame and scandal of their family.
So we found the young girl who treated him nice. He went to his papa to ask his advice. Papa said, "Son, I got to say no.
Girl is your sister, but your mama don't know."
Ah, woe, ah, me. Shame and scandal of the family. Ah, woe, ah, me. Shame and scandal of the family.
So the weeks went by. The boy looked around. Soon the best cook on the island he found. He went to his papa to name the day. His papa looked at him and to him he did say, "You can't marry that girl. I got to say no.
Girl is your sister, but your mama don't know."
Ah, woe, ah, me. Shame and scandal of the family. Ah, woe, ah, me. Shame and scandal of the family.
Well, the years went by. He wished he was dead. He had 17 girls, but still wasn't wed. When he asked his father, Papa'd always say, "No.
Girls are your sisters, but your mama don't know."
Ah, woe, ah, me. Shame and scandal of the family. Ah, woe, ah, me. Shame and scandal of the family. His mama and he bowed his head. He told his mama what his papa had said. His mama said, "Son, go man, go. Your papa
papa ain't your papa, but your papa don't know.
I would be shaving scandal of the family. I would be shaving scandal of the family.
Here's a song about Charlie and the MTA right now.
Well, let me tell you the story of a man named Charlie on that tragic, fateful day. He put dentist in his pocket, just his wife and family went to ride on the MTA.
Well, did he ever return? No, he never returned. And his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever in the streets of Boston. He's the man who never returned.
Charlie handed in his dime at the 2nd Street station, and he knew he had to change at Main. When he got there, the conductor told him one more nickel. Charlie couldn't get off of that train.
Well, did he ever return? No, he never returned. And his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever in the streets of Boston. He's the man who never returned.
Now all night long, Charlie rides through the station crying, what will become of me? How can I afford to see my sister in Chelsea, all my cousins in Roxbury?
But did he ever return? No, he never returned. And his fate is still unlearned.
He may ride
through hell and keep the streets of Boston. The man who never returned.
Charlie's wife goes down to the Scully Square station every day at 2:15. And through the open window she has Charlie's sandwich. The train comes rumbling through.
Well, did he ever return? No, he never returned. And his fate is still unlearned. He may ride forever in the streets of Boston. He's the man who never returned.
Get him, George.
Watch his fingers and never leave his hand.
Little North Carolina boy, George Grove. Now you citizens of Boston, don't you think it's a scandal how the people have to pay and pay? Fight the fair and green, vote for George O'Brien. Get old Charlie off that end.
Nick Reynolds, one of the old guys. Boy, it's hotter than a country boy's air rifle up here.
All right.
Thank you. Throughout history, there have been many songs written about the Eternal Triangle. This next one tells the story of Mr. Grayson, a beautiful woman, a condemned man named Tom Dooley. When the sun rises tomorrow, Tom Dooley must hang. We'd love to have you sing along with this.
Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry.
Everybody try it now.
Hang down your head, Tom Dooley, before you're bound to die.
I met her on the mountain. There I took her life. Met her on the mountain. Stabbed her with my knife.
Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry.
Hang down your head, Tom Dooley, before you're bound to die.
This time tomorrow, reckon where I'll be. Hadn't it been for Grayson, I'd have been in Tennessee.
Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry.
Everybody.
Boy, well, hang down your head, Tom Dooley, before you're bound to die.
This time tomorrow, reckon where I'll be. Down in some lonesome valley, hanging from a wild oak tree.
Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry,
oh boy.
Well, I hang down your head, Tom Dooley, before you're bound to die.
Oh well, now, boy,
hang down your head. Die before you're bound to die.
I'll talk about this song.
Will you? Tom Dooley sold the most singles for the Kingston Trio, by far, of any single release we had. But the most requested song over all the years, 37 or 36, I forget what, how many Bob thinks we've been together, was done by Bob Shane all by himself.
What do you say?
This song was written in 1932 by an anonymous composer in Phoenix, Arizona. It was collected by the Seavers family from Fresno. Mr. and Mrs. Seavers were on their honeymoon in Phoenix at the time. At the time we learned this song from them, they had a son named Tom Seavers who was 9 years old then. And he was the baseball pitcher who he ended up to be. His older sister, Katie, was going to school at Stanford, and she was dating one of the fellows in our group. And this is before we started the group. This song is probably the greatest song I've ever sung in my life, and I've sung it more than anything I've ever sung. I've sung this song 35,000 times, and at least I know it. Yeah. But it is still the best song I've ever sung because it has no real... It doesn't have a real direct thing, it's an overall thing. And if you know the song, you know what I mean. A fellow walks into a bar in San Francisco, and he sits down at a bar stool and orders a drink. And about 5 minutes later, the most beautiful woman he's ever seen in his life sits three bar stools down from him. There's nobody else in the place, and he's just sitting there staring at her. And she catches this out of the corner of her eye, and she turns to him, and she says, "Sir, for $50, I'll do anything you want, but you have to ask in three words or less." And the guy says, "You'll do anything for me for $50, and all I have to ask in three words or less?" She said, "That's right." And he thought for a minute, and he said, "Paint my house." Man had his priorities right, let's face it. Scotch and soda, mud in your eye.
Baby, do I feel high over me? Oh my. Do I feel high? Dry martini, ginger gin. Oh, what a spell you've got me in. Oh, my. Do I feel high? Think that I'm just bragging, but I could feel the way I do, still be on the wagon. All I need is one of your smiles, sunshine of your eyes on me. Oh my, do I feel higher than a kite can fly? Get me loving, baby, I feel high.
Thank you. Great song.
We'd like to do a little melody that we wrote in 1958. When we wrote this song, it meant very little. Today it means even less.
Myself a brand new house, 5 miles out of town. Got myself a brand new car, $30 down. Got myself a gal named Sue, treats me really fine. She's my baby,
she's your baby,
and I love her all the time. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. Trip, traveling all around. I got a gal and her name is Sue, prettiest gal in town. Sets my mind to worrying, every time I'm gone, I'll be home tonight. So I won't be worried. Oh, it takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. I'm worried now.
Bobby's in the living room holding hands with Sue. George is at that big front door about to come on through. I'm here in the closet. Oh, Lord, what shall I do?
Come out of the closet.
We're worried now.
But not if you don't want to.
But we won't be worried long.
It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. It takes a worried man to sing a worried song. I'm worried now.
Thank you very much. This is a beautiful auditorium.
Yeah.
Thank you. We'd like to do the first song we ever recorded in 1922. A wonderful, wonderful little ditty goes like this.
Two and three jolly coachmen sat in an English tavern. Three jolly coachmen sat in an English tavern. And they decided, and they decided, and they decided to have another flagon on me. Landlord filled a flowing bowl until it done run over. Landlord filled a flowing bowl until it done run over. For tonight the mayor I be, for tonight the mayor I be, for tonight the mayor I be. Tomorrow we'll be sober.
What?
It's only a song.
Here's to the man who drinks dark ale and goes to bed quite mellow. Here's to the man who drinks dark ale and goes to bed quite mellow. He lives as he ought to live, lives as he ought to live, lives as he ought to live, and dies a jolly good fellow. Ho, ho, ho.
Here's to the man who makes water pure and goes to bed quite sober.
Here's to the man who makes water pure and goes to bed quite sober.
He falls as the leaves do fall,
falls as the leaves do fall, falls as the leaves do fall.
He'll die before October.
Here's to the maid who steals a kiss and runs to tell her mother. Here's to the maid who steals a kiss and runs to tell her mother. She's a foolish, foolish thing. She's a foolish, foolish thing. She's a foolish, foolish thing. For she'll not get another. Pity.
Well, I've always said that.
Here's to the maid who steals a kiss and stays to deal another. Here's to the maid who steals a kiss and stays to steal another.
Oh, goody.
She's a boon to all mankind. She's a boon to all mankind. She's a boon to all mankind. For she'll soon be a mother.
He rode easy in the saddle, he was tall and lean. At first you thought nothing but a streak of mean could make a man look so downright strong. One look in his eyes and you knowed you was wrong. He was a mountain of a man, I want you to know. He could reach hot hell or freezing snow. Carried a Bible in a canvas sack. The folks just called him the Reverend Mr. Black. He was poor as a beggar, but he rode like a king. Sometimes in the evening I could hear him say,
hey,
are you that poor? Never I could have thought this man in black was soft, had any yellow up his back. I gave that notion up the day a lumberjack came in. It wasn't to pray. Yeah, he kicked open the meeting house door. Then he cussed everybody up and down the floor. And then when things got quiet in the place, he walked up and cussed in the preacher's face. He hit that reverend like the kick of a mule. To my way of thinking, took a pure fool that turned the other cheek to that lumberjack. That's what he did, the Reverend Mr. Black. He stood like a rock, a man among men. Then he let that lumberjack hit him again. And then with a voice as kind as could be, he cut him down like a big oak tree. When he said,
hey, hey, you got one.
Been many years since we had to part. I guess I learned his ways by heart. I can still hear his sermons ring down in the valley where he used to sing. I followed him, and I don't regret it.
hope I'll always be a credit to his memory. Cause I want you to understand, the Reverend Mr. Black was my old man.
Hey! Now you got the world.
Going home. We're going home tomorrow for a couple of weeks.
Well, no matter where I wander, I know I'll always find a welcome. At the end of every journey, there'll be friendly people waiting. California would not hold me, though I love her timber mountains, work her fields and work her orchards, up and down her central valley.
I have driven open highways across the golden Utah Valley. Now watch the rivers gently gliding. I wave my hand to friendly people.
California not hold me, though I love her timber mountains, work her fields and work her orchards, up and down her central valley.
Folks who know me call me a drifter. They don't know I'll stop my rambling. Somebody's gonna make me settle down.
I'm going home, Lord, I'm going home. I'm going home, Lord, I'm going home.
Well, no matter where I wander, I know I'll always find the welcome. At the end of every journey, there'll be friendly
sitting, that's where you'll be on video.
Thank you. You guys have been great. Thank you. We'll see you soon, I hope.